Okay guys, I'm going to introduce you to the 3D tool in Illustrator. I'm just going to introduce it to you guys because we're learning. I actually don't think it's the best tool to use in the world. Like if I was going to try to draw a bag like this where it's at like a three-quarter perspective, I'd probably just get the pen tool and draw it. Or there's so much 3D software available now, like maybe I would just open up Clo3D and draft the pattern pieces and have them make it 3D. But you can do it in Illustrator and it's okay, and I'm just going to show you. I did make a video to show you guys how to look at lengths of lines. I kind of wanted to start with that first. Just so I get like a decent perspective or like proportion of this tote. So here we go. I drew this little line. This is like how wide it is. But the problem is if I open up my info window, it's going to tell me how much space my diagonal line is taking, like how wide it is and how tall it is. But it's not telling me the actual length. Like, so if I were to rotate it and make it straight, because that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make a straight rectangle, and then I'm going to turn that into 3D. Anyways, it's not giving me the length of this. This line is actually longer than what the width is. But there is kind of a trick in Illustrator to look at it. You have to open up not info, but document info. So here's document info. Okay, there's a little sandwich, right? This is really deep. It's hidden. And I guess you would say objects. Yes. Cool. So now it's telling me information about this path, and it's telling me that the length is 1.98, which you can see is slightly longer than 1.96, how wide it is. So this is helpful. Again, you probably, you know, would be using a pattern drafting software or something else if you are getting this technical, but I just wanted to show you because not everyone has access to that kind of software. So anyways, I am just gonna note like, hey, this is 1.98 length. And then how tall is my bag? You know, and it can tell you the lengths of like curved lines and what. So I just kind of estimated a line to kind of start with, and it looks like the length of this guy is 2.7. That's fine. I'm gonna make it kind of an estimate. And then now I'm gonna draw a rectangle. So I'm gonna switch to the rectangle tool. I like to just hit the letter M, and you can just click one time, and we can type in 1.98 by 2.7. And that's just trying to help me with like the proportions, make sure that I don't draft a rectangle that's like too fat or too short. It doesn't really matter because you can always change it later, to be honest with you. I'm gonna delete those guys. Okay, cool. So here is my rectangle. So now I'm ready to make this guy 3D. So here is the magic. Maybe I'll just give it a fill color. I don't even know if I need the outline. Maybe it's a good idea to have it. I'm not sure. Anyways, here's my red box. It doesn't have an outline. I'm going to go up to effect, and it's one of the first ones. It's 3D. They like to do things in alphabetical, so numbers go first. And just choose the first one. We're going to extrude and bevel, I guess. Okay, so it's kind of popping out a little bit towards the right, but my photograph is popping out to the left. So to mimic it, you can just like turn this guy, kind of like that. Okay, I'm trying to get as straight as possible. There we go. You can't really see the top of it, so I'm kind of changing it a little bit like that. Okay, I think that's good. It takes it a minute to kind of catch up. Maybe we can even make this a little bit wider. Whoa, hello. Okay, that looks a little funny to me. Yeah, a little bit funny. Sometimes it just takes a minute to catch up, I think. Yeah, again, not my most favorite tool. What am I going to say? Because it's really wide to the left. I don't know why it's doing that. There we go. Oh, there we go. Let me just maybe like a little, I'm just kind of playing. Maybe I'll do it like that. Okay. I think that's good. And I guess I can say, okay. I mean, there are some choices too about like the shading. Like I actually like the wireframe probably the best, but it doesn't really matter because you can always change it later. So maybe I'll just leave it as plastic shading. And I'll say, okay. All right, so there it is. So I'm gonna go in and change it because our top, it's snapped closed, and then the bottom is wide open. So I'm gonna have to change it. So I'm gonna say object, I'm gonna expand the appearance. So now it is a vectorized object that I can change. It's also really straight where this guy has curves. So this is where I'm like, maybe it was faster to just draw it with a pen tool, right? But I guess if you do it this way, you know for sure it's all proportional. You know, you're doing it right, maybe. I don't know. Okay, so anyways, I guess what I could do is maybe grab this and try to bring it closer somehow. Maybe I should change the colors to make it a little easier to see. Okay, let's see. And then I want to add, I'm gonna hit P plus and add a couple anchor points to it. And then I'm going to add handlebars to the anchor points I just drew. Okay. Adding handlebars. Okay. Hitting the letter A so I can bring out my anchor points a little. Okay. I'm going to hit P plus and just add an anchor point to this guy. And I'm going to move him to the back layer. So I'm going to select it. I'm going to say Command X. Command B, so it's on the very bottom layer. Maybe I made it too far. So I'm holding shift as I bring it in. And then maybe I should obviously make this guy somehow round. So I'm gonna hit P plus. And then I'm gonna go over to the handlebars here. Give this guy a handlebar. A, kind of pull it out. Okay. Maybe you come in more. Oopsies. If I'm going to bring it in, I'm going to bring both of these guys in. Down a bit. Okay. And I wish I had caught this, but I didn't. So I can just manually move it. Zoom in. I'm really far. Okay, that's pretty good. A. Okay. So now I'm kind of just like trying to get it to look okay. I don't know. Again, I'm like, should I have just drawn it instead of trying to use the 3D tool? Okay. So, anyways, once you get it where you think it's like decent, then you should do the handle, handles. You know what? Oh my gosh. I just feel like I'm totally not even using the 3D tool at this point. I'm just like changing it all. I'm gonna make it a little wider. Okay. Let's see here. Yes. Okay, good. Still recording. I know I'm not used to this phone stuff. Okay, so I'm back. Maybe this guy comes down a little. Okay, so you can kind of play with it. I think what I want to do now is select all of this and give it a black outline. Okay, whoops, don't really feel like that worked. Let me try one more time. Black. There we go. That kind of worked. Okay, and then for the straps, I guess I'm gonna copy this line. Commands. Oh, yes. Okay. So I'm going to use the blend tool to do the straps. We have been introduced to this, I think, in a previous module. So I'm going to select these four anchor points. I selected them with the white arrow by holding shift. I'm not selecting the top. I'm just going to say Command C, and then I'm going to deselect everything. So it's not going to be part of the group because I think this thing is automatically grouped when I, what expanded the appearance. So now I'm going to say Command F. And then I'm just gonna say select inverse. I'm gonna lock everything. Okay, so apparently my lines I drew, I gave them a fill. I don't want them to have a fill. I'm gonna get rid of that. And now I'm gonna use the blend tool. I'm gonna double click it and I'm gonna change the specified steps to two because I just want like two straps in the middle. And then I should be able to click the top anchor point of the first edge and then the other one and then put two straps there in the middle. Then I can make them thicker by changing back to the black arrow. Oh, you know what I should do? I think I'm going to expand the appearance. I'm going to say expand. I guess okay. And then I'm going to say object ungroup. And then I don't need these outer lines. They were just kind of there to for me to make these middle ones. So my two middle ones, I selected both of them by holding shift because they are ungrouped. And now I'm going to make them wide. Like, how wide should my straps be? Is that too wide? Maybe that's a little too wide. I'll let you guys kind of figure it out. Then I'm gonna hit P and just kind of connect them at the top. I also feel like they're just too close together. So the blending tool just put them smack in the middle, but I think this design has obviously a wider middle. So I guess I should move them over. So maybe I'll delete my connection. And I'll start by just kind of scooting them a little bit. There we go. Maybe what I should have done is like blended it with like multiple steps. And then just kept the outer two. Like maybe I could have done three. Maybe that's what I should have done. Okay, I'm gonna do that then. So I'm going to edit undo a few times. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay. Okay, that's selected. Let's see if I can change it. I don't know. Oh, yeah, I did. Okay, good. There we go. So now it's three steps instead of two. And then now I can go object, expand, say okay. And I'm going to ungroup it. So object ungroup, I like to hit command shift G. And I don't need these outer ones. So I'm just going to delete them so they're out of my way. And I don't need the middle one either. Okay, maybe that's better. Okay, now we're going to make it thicker again, however wide you think it should be. I'm going to the letter P and I'm going to just connect them. Okay, so then now what I want to do is I want to make this 3D as well. So here, and I should have written down my 3D measurements. Ah, I'm so bad. That's what I should have done. Okay, so anyways, we're going to go to Effect, 3D, Extrude again. And it would have been nice if I typed in these exact same measurements so that I don't have to, like, guesstimate here. Live and learn. Oh, and I am having trouble operating this today. Up, 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 up. It does not want to go up. It does not. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Yeah, typing them would have been better. Close enough, I suppose. I definitely don't want them 50. That's what as wide as my tote. Maybe like 5 is okay. I'm going to look at it through my wireframe. I don't really see anything. So I wonder if maybe this is... Oh, there we go. Try turning it like that. Okay. I mean, it's something. I'm just going to say okay. And now let's zoom in, and I don't need all of it. I don't need like this stuff on the left. So, I'm going to expand appearance, and now it's like vector lines and I can delete what I don't want. It's all grouped together. I can try just double clicking and let's see, maybe I'll just grab what I want. I think I'm going to hit the letter I and just give it a fill. Sometimes that's a little bit easier for me to see. And I want to grab this middle guy. I'm going to double click again. Click. Okay. Right? Yeah. I want to grab you. I want to grab this thing. I want to grab this guy down here. I think I accidentally deselected what I wanted. I'm going to zoom in. I'm having trouble. Okay. I want to pick you and I don't want you. I want this thing. Uh-oh. Okay. I'm not sure what to do about that. What's going on? Trying to get, Okay, hold on. I'm gonna double click. I'm gonna hit the letter A. Maybe I'll make this middle one a different color. Yes. Okay, so I want that green thing. So I'm gonna pick you, double click. Okay, so the green thing was selected. Okay, well, there's the green thing. Ah, maybe what I need to do is just select the ones I want and change it to the same color. And that will be easier for me to figure out what's what. Because this grouping business is a little crazy today. Okay, good. So I only want the green stuff. So now I'm gonna hit the magic wand and I'm making sure everything's the same thing as green. I'm gonna say command X. Then I'm gonna hit the letter V and select this and just delete it. And I'll say command F so it pastes it right in the same spot. And this way, it's kind of protruding a little bit. It does have those weird lines, so I can use my Pathfinder tool to get rid of that. There we go. And I'll use the black arrow and select them because they're not grouped anymore, and I can unite, so they're kind of smoother. Okay, did that unite? Yeah. Okay, cool. And then we can see, obviously, we have some issues at the bottom, so... I mean, again, I guess I will just, maybe I'll just delete. Let's see, what should I do? I guess I'll use the white arrow and just move this. Oh, what are you? You're a little handlebar that I did not mean to pull out. There we are. Okay, and then maybe you come up a little bit. You can come down without changing your shape too much. Okay. And then I guess the same over here. Command zero. Okay, and then I can maybe just group these guys together, Command G, I'll copy it, Command C, I'll deselect, say Command B, and then scoot it over. So it kind of looks like there's some straps on the backside too. And then anyways, you would just go in and maybe draw some kind of like little shading detail here. So I guess this side, let me say object unlock all. Maybe this side is the same color. I guess it could be a different color because it's at an angle. And then your shading detail, you could also say is the same color, but then maybe you just bring it down on your shader so it's like a little bit different if you wanted. Zooming. Okay. Anyways, I just wanted to introduce you guys to the 3D tool, see if that helps you draw this guy or if you would rather just use the pen tool to draw it. But, yeah, let me know what you guys think. I'm excited to see how you guys use it and how you guys figure out to solve this guy. So.